In this video, we'll look at the difference between coefficients and subscripts. The coefficients, those are the numbers that go in front of compounds. Here we have a 2, it's in front of the H2, or the 2 in front of the H2O. And this 2, this coefficient, they apply to all of the elements, the H's and the O here. If we don't have a coefficient, like with the O2, we assume that to be 1. Subscripts are different. They're smaller, and they only apply to one element. So this 2 applies to the H, this 2 applies to the O, we have a 2 here with the H, and if there's nothing written, we consider there to be a 1 here. Subscripts are smaller, and they kind of go below the elements, much like a submarine goes below the water. Let's just look at one part of this equation here. Let's look at 2H2O to understand the difference between coefficients and subscripts. Let's start with the coefficient, the large number in front of the water molecule. This 2 means we have two H2O molecules, two water molecules, and that they're separate, and we could show that like this. So in this sense, the coefficient, it's just a ratio or a number. We have two water molecules. We can write each one as just H2O. A key idea is that when we have the coefficient, we have our two water molecules, they're not chemically bonded. They're separate molecules. Now let's talk about the subscript. When we look at the subscript in H2O, that tells us that we have two hydrogens, 1, 2, and 1 oxygen. And because these element symbols right here are together, they're chemically bonded. They are stuck together. Note that with our water molecule here, there's nothing written after the oxygen atom. We assume that to be just 1. So we have 1 oxygen atom in this H2O molecule. So pause for a second and try this. With this 2H2O here from our chemical equation, how many total hydrogen and total oxygen atoms do we have? So if we count them up down here with our two water molecules, we have 1, 2, 3, 4 hydrogens and 1, 2 oxygens. We could also multiply 2 times 2, that would give us the 4 hydrogens, and then 1 times the 2 to give us these 2 oxygen atoms. So pause and give this a try. How many hydrogen atoms and oxygen atoms do I have when I have a coefficient of 5 in front of H2O? You could count all of these up down here since we have 5 water molecules, or you could say 2 times 5, that gives us 10 hydrogens, and 1 times 5, that gives us 5 oxygens. But keep in mind, they're all separate water molecules. The individual H2Os, they're not bonded together. It's these 2 hydrogens here forming the chemical bond with the 1 oxygen. Let's go back to our original chemical equation. When we balance chemical equations, we change the coefficients, the numbers in front, and we do that so all of the atoms add up to be the same on each side. I have 4 hydrogens here, and I have 1, 2, 3, 4 here. I have 2 oxygens here, and I have 1, 2 here. So in the chemical equation, we conserved mass. We didn't lose any molecules, but they were rearranged. And these coefficients, they help us make sure we have the right number. The subscripts, they help us make sure we have the right compounds. So let's take a look what would happen if we changed a subscript. So what would happen if I was balancing a chemical equation, instead of H2O, I changed the subscript to H2O2? First off, we have a very different looking molecule here. And because we've changed its molecular structure, it has different properties. For example, we drink water. We're actually made up of mostly water. What would happen if you drank hydrogen peroxide? Nothing good, that's to be certain. In fact, the hydrogen peroxide sold in stores is only about 3%. The rest is water. If you touched stronger hydrogen peroxide, like 30%, this is what would happen to your fingers. So we can't change the subscripts. Once we change those subscripts, we've made an entirely new compound with different properties. And when we're balancing equations, we aren't trying to make new compounds. We're trying to get the ratios right between what we react together and what's produced in the chemical reaction. Before we wrap up here, pause for a moment and think about why we can't change subscripts, but we can change the coefficients in a chemical reaction. If you can't answer that question, go back and watch the video again and make sure you understand why. This is Dr. B with the difference between subscripts and coefficients. Thanks for watching.